Just announced, Robert Whittaker is going to jump right back in. Coming back, UFC 254, number one contenders bout. Now, that changes everything. I really like it when this happens, and I'm speaking as a fan. I like it when something's on it. When something's on the match, and you only got so many titles. You call it an interim, you call it a BMF, you call it undisputed. You still only got so many, so you got to put something on it for me. And there's a lot of great matches that we look at. We go, well, that should be a number one contenders match. But every now and then it gets declared that when that happens, there's something special. Cannonier versus Whittaker. And you know what? Cannonier is the right guy. Cannonier is the Leon Edwards of 185 pounds. Where you sit back and go, how much does this guy need to do? Yet at the same time, while I say that, something's missing. Something's missing. I don't know what it is, but there's just something there. Cannonier is a very interesting guy. If you guys haven't followed his career, he was in like Alaska doing like trucking. I'm very close, if not perfectly correct. Comes into the UFC as a heavyweight. He does fine. That's the most you could say for him. His career ended. You wouldn't tease him. You wouldn't brag about him. He did fine. Drops down to light heavyweight. He does a little more than fine, but not much. If his career ended, he'd have gone two weight classes and he would have done a little more than fine. He drops down to middleweight. This guy's perfect. Hadn't lost a fight. One of the wins is over the greatest the division has ever seen in Anderson Silva. I mean, look, is there anybody that's ever beaten Anderson Silva who did not instantly matter? Answer that question, no. No, there's not. I had a career made losing to Anderson Silva. I mean, just by example, you tell me a guy that's beat Anderson Silva who hasn't instantly had a mandate. And I'll tell you his name. It's Jared Cannonier. But you can't totally say something's missing. If I was to come out today and tell you Cannonier is going to go and fight for the world championship, you'd say fine. But you'd have a little bit of an argument, a little bit of question, a little bit of how did we get there. So when I just talk about something's missing, this is what's missing. They've solved it. Dana has solved the problem. What's missing is a fight with the former champion, current number one contender, where we say ahead of time, let's see how you deal with pressure. Because I'm going to put some pressure on it. You're not getting your big gift ahead of time. I'm telling you ahead of time, here's what's on this. Make or break, up to you. Okay. Got to see how a guy reacts like that. Got to see how he does in a main event. Got to see how he does in Fiverr. I mean, there's just a lot of things where when you're looking at a guy like Cannonier, and I know I compared him to Leon, but I think it's a fair comparison. You look at it and go, boy, he sure does deserve it. But you have a hard time finishing your own thought. When you look at Whittaker, Whittaker never quite got the credit that he was due for that win over Till. I mean, there was a lot in that. Look, guys, anything in life that goes up must come down. And this was a down in many ways from an outsider looking in for Whittaker. Every fight Whittaker's had in a period of time has been for a world championship because he's bringing it. The previous fight that Whittaker had where he suffers the first knockout of his life, which makes many guys question themselves, also happened to be in front of a record-setting crowd in his hometown. Now he's got to go to another town. Now he's got absolutely no crowd. Oh, by the way, forget that championship I talked about. I mean, everything was off for Whittaker. This was a mental battle. He passed it. So it makes me feel very good that Whittaker is now only one away from a title fight. It makes me feel very good that Jared, who's done everything right in three different weight classes, works hard, is just pushing his way through and living his dream, is now one away from a world title. There's something about a match where you never have to get into the X's and O's. We just spent 5 minutes together. We all had a lot of fun, didn't we? But we've never talked about, think about the jab of Cannonier and think about those leg kicks of Whittaker. When you can set the X's and O's aside and you can just realize there's a lot on this, there's dreams on this, there's hard work on this, they are now one step away. We are in the semi-final round of the world championship. There's something special. This is the right fight. I like this fight. I'm excited for this fight, and I want to know, do you agree?